Hello and welcome back everyone. I'm Blumana Banana and this is ARK. I'm once again here at the setting screen for my local ARK. I am not 100% sure about most of these things, but I guess I kind of know the most of them now. I think, well, the structures in range, I can leave it at that, that's okay. The day cycle speed, I'm still not 100% convinced, but hopefully this will give us a long day and, well, a really fast night. Maybe let's keep the cycle speed at the middle. The dino damage is exactly what it kind of sounds like. You put this up, you take a lot of, dinos deal a lot of damage, and if you put this down, dinos deal not that much damage. To be honest, I'm gonna set this to reset to default because it's, as you can see, not everything is in, it's not in the middle. It's actually at, I think, a third or something. So, night speed down, day speed up, cycle speed down, dino damage, let's try something and put this all the way down. I'm really curious what this does. Let's put the player damage, let's leave the player, let's up player damage by the maximum. To the maximum, I like this going to the max thingy because I kind of know what the normal thing is, so let's try what the maximum actually is and how this scales. Structure damage, I don't actually rightly know what this is, but I don't know how. Well, I think how much damage these barricades deal or something like that. The player resistance is actually how much damage you take, but I have no idea what this slider actually means, because there are no numbers attached to them. Interestingly enough, the command is actually, let me take a look at them, I should have, very professional, I know. I have a list right here somewhere. Yeah. There it is. So the resistance multiplier actually specifies the amount of damage you take. Pretty obvious. But a value of 0.5 results in a player taking half damage, while a value of 2 would result in taking double damage. So actually the resistance multiplier is the lower you set it, the less damage you take. So let's see if this is true for this slider as well. So, in that case, let's keep the dino resistance at the standard values. So we can test the player damage on dinosaurs, that's actually what we want. We still need to test the XP multiplier at the maximum. I like the taming speed at the maximum because it only takes 10 minutes to tame a T-Rex or something like that, and I don't like this taming grind thingy. The harvest amount on the maximum was a bit too high for my taste, so let's put it at 66% or something, or 75. The player character water drain is, well, how much, how specifies the amount of water you have to, well, no, it's a stupid way to explain it. It determines the intervals, the size of the interval in this where you have to drink. No, this doesn't make any sense as well. How fast you get thirsty. I think that's the easiest way to say it. So. It should be that if you put this to the high end, you should get thirsty very often. So let's put this all the way down and see how often we have to drink. The same goes for food. The same goes for the dinosaurs because I don't want them to eat that much. Because why the hell should I? Let's put the stamina drain also all the way down. And as well, let's keep these at, keep the food drain a bit down, not all the way down. Let's try this first. But the stamina drain should specify how much longer we can, well, attack with the dinosaur and sprint. So let's try this. The player character health recovery is how fast you recover your HP after you get damaged. Let's put this to, well, maximum amount, yes, let's try this. These settings create a pretty easy arc, I know. Don't Well, if you don't like it, it's your problem. You can specify your arc via these sliders as much as you want. And the last thing is, well, the dino count, how many dinos there, well, these, how much dinosaurs spawn, how many dinosaurs spawn, actually. The higher, they should increase the amount of dinos that spawn, so put it up to the max, let's see how many dinos we can spawn here. The harvest health is pretty interesting. This specifies the amount of hits you can, well, or the amount of hits that, for example, a rock can take before it breaks, or a tree before it falls down. So if you put this to a very high, well, to put this to the high end, it should, in theory, allow us to take more swings at a rock, and therefore it should yield more resources. So let's try that. In combination with the harvest amount, we should get a lot. Let's put this all the way up. We should get a lot of resources just from one harvesting trip. The PvE structure decay period is, I think, something that we don't really need. That's more a server thing, because if you don't log into your character, or and you build something on a server and you don't log into your character for, I think, a week or something like that, it's a standard setting, they get destroyed, or they can be claimed by anyone or something like that. I'm not 100% sure, but that's just to keep the server clean. And last but not least, the resource respawn period. I'm still not convinced with all the labels, to be honest, because it specifies the respawn rate. So the higher the values, it should respawn more frequently. So I have no idea if I put the slider up, do I increase the time period in between the respawns, or do I increase the frequency? Because it doesn't make any sense in this case. It's not 100% well specified, actually. So we have to see. We'd have to try and see if we put this all the way up and try. So these are the settings. As you can see, it should result in a pretty easy mode game. But still, let's just try and see how it goes. Once again, some of these sliders are, in my opinion, not named very well. The naming is a bit off, because the how you would write it down in your ini file, your game, so no, game user game file. No, I have no idea how it's called. But the file that specifies your server settings, if you have a server, then well, for instance, the resource respawn period, the last slider, is called resource respawn period multiplier. So it's actually the same, almost the same name, but it's then explained with specifies the scaling factor. Specifies the scaling factor for the respawn rate of resource nodes. Higher values causes nodes to respawn more frequently. Yeah, if that's the explanation, then why the hell are you using such a confusing name for it? Just write it down. It's actually a frequency, not a period, so yeah, I don't know. Alright, we tamed this level 1 T-Rex in the last episode. Let's just leave her here. Let's get her aggression level to aggressive, and let's enable wandering, and let's just leave her here, and she should just kill everybody inside. Oh yeah, she found her first victim, I think. Or not? No. Enable wandering, by the way, just sets the dinosaur to a, well, natural, I don't know, moving around like they would if they weren't tamed. So she now runs around in this vicinity and, well, strikes terror in the hearts of every prey she can find. I actually want my... Come on, I want my rep. That should be on point. That's interesting. I want my... Could you please? Yeah, now it's following me. Okay. Since there are some things that we need to test, we have our pickaxe right here. Let's see how many swings we can take this rock. Alright, I have counted them in my head, that's why I didn't say anything. But I think it was 22 or something like that. I got a bit distracted by your WhatsApp message that you might heard. Terribly sorry, that's very unprofessional, and I'm gonna put my phone away. Right now. Alright, so we're back at this beautiful river, as you can see right here. The resource multiplier is insane. I think it took us, 23 or something hits to take down this this rock. Let's see how many swings we can take at this tree. Okay, well, that's interesting. I can't even move anymore. We just got 88 wood out of a single tree, and it almost broke our hatchet. That's interesting. So if you're into that, I can actually, recommend using this setting. Well, as I said, it results in a very easy mode game. The other thing that we wanted to try is damage settings, right? I need to still take a look at our speed multiplier and stuff like that. Okay, I think I set the time. Do we have set the dino stamina stuff somewhere? Because as you can see, the sprint thing doesn't, the stamina meter doesn't even drop just by the smallest amount. Let me get off it and try to sprint a bit. You know what? It could be that infinite stats is still active from the last episode. Whoop! Ah, damn it. Actually, it would have been good if I'd have taken some damage right here. Okay, we can try our luck with, where's my scorpion? Ah, there it is. Because there are two scorpions over there, and we can try if we are invincible still. Because it could be that we're still in god mode and infinite stats from the last time. But usually it doesn't work like that. Usually you have to redo that in the settings. Come on, really, you stupid son of a gun. Stop blocking me. No, but it looks like we lost a little bit of stamina. Ugh. No, we are still in. We are still in god mode. Otherwise, that would have looked... Whoa! 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 steps for a level 12. Interesting. And look at the chitin we're getting out of that. Okay, that's a bit hard, to be honest. It's a bit too much, I think. Oh, there are a lot of scorpions here. Let me stab these guys. Let's see if I can get them unconscious, it would be interesting. Yeah, one's unconscious. The other one too. Nice. Ah, almost dead. Let's kill him. Ah, he too. Don't care. Yeah, what I really want to do now is... This is insane. This is just a... Look, what the sh... Oh, 55 chitin out of 2 scorpions. That's just amazing. You know how long you would have to farm for these? I don't know. The problem is scorpions are aggressive against everything. And wait a second, I need to turn off the... As you can see, I was on the server just some time ago. I tried to record a tutorial on how to set up a server, but I'm not convinced. I'm just not convinced. So let's try if this is working. Let's set it to 8 o'clock in the morning because I want some daylight. Ah, that's better. And so it works. So we need to disable infinite stats, and of course, well, I can type God. That should be. Oh, there it is. Boom. So now we should be okay. Are we using stamina now? That's a question. No, it doesn't look like it. We might only have been in God mode, not in infinite stats mode. That's interesting. As I said in the last episode, I used God mode and infinite stats mode for the taming process because I just, it's so boring. I sat there, I stared at the dinosaur screen, the stats screen, and I opened up a CSGO stream. Oh, nice. It was just not funny. I wasn't interested in it. Every few minutes I just looked up the stats of the dinosaur. Didn't need to administer any narcotics. I think he or she, the T-Rex that we just released over there, I think it took two or three prime meat to tame her. So yeah. Let's try our luck with this. Why isn't... Is he even... I don't get this. This is pretty strange. Maybe the resistance multiplier that we set... No, did we set the resistance multiplier to a high amount or a low amount? I can't remember. It's very strange. That guy's running around like a headless chicken. That's okay. But I actually want to try my luck with a damage multiplier or something like that. You stay there, and now I'll try to fight the Stegosaurus, level 2, that's okay. My armor is full leather, or hide, actually. Oh, wait a second, I have to put him to passive, too. Oh, he's neutral, perfect. So let's try this. So, 1, 2... I'm still can't be hit. What's up with that? Is it that I take so little damage that let me put God again in this console? No, look at that. What's up with this? Maybe the Well, let's just leave him and decompose, because I don't think that's not fair. Maybe the settings, the server settings, the resistance multiplier on, the player, and the damage multiplier that we put on the dinosaurs resulted in negative or in zero damage. So maybe because I have a hide armor, which kind of gives me, I don't know, there must be. There's somewhere is this armor stat, yeah. So we have 100 armor. I don't know how armor really works in this game, to be honest. But maybe because of our resistance and damage multipliers, these dinosaurs can't pierce the armor, and that's why it results in zero damage, and that's why the T-Rex here can't kill the Brontosaurus. That's interesting. That's very, very interesting. And I think it's completely bugged and results in zero, well, in a stupid gameplay. Also, I think it's pretty cool that T-Rex are more interested in prey than in players. So that's a plus. But yeah, cool. That's something that we found out. If you put the damage multiplier all the way down, the resistance multiplier all the way up, it seems like dinosaurs can't deal damage anymore. That's amazing. That's amazing. But our tame T-Rex killed a level 4 Pteranodon. My god, why can't I remember this name? You know, the flying dinosaurs. So it seems like either the pteranodons have a very low resistance multiplier, because as you can see, the Stilo is trying to bite the parasaurus, and the parasaurus is like, meh, what? And now, this looks a bit, well, maybe I should censor this. Well, yeah, we saw nothing. But it also seems like the multiplier for stamina and stuff like that makes it so we can almost sprint infinitely. Let's just see how long we can sprint. Still, I'm not convinced. Maybe we have infinite stats, maybe we haven't. Maybe we are in god mode, maybe we are not. But since all the dinosaurs can't kill each other, I do think that it's not that we are bugged, it's more or less the resistance thing. Okay, let's try this. 1, 2. Nah, that's not what I want. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I think I could just take this 9 times. And look at that, the Dillo can't kill a dodo. That's hilarious. That's just insane. Let's drop the fiber. I just can't believe what I'm seeing right now. That's... oh, the fiber isn't even the problem right here. 200... Oh my god, that's drop half the flint, I think. It was all flint. Oh, well. Well, like, I care! I can't just... Oh, and the stone, right? We picked up so many stones. Let's get rid of them as well. I don't know what to say about this. These server settings are definitely not I can't recommend them. It's kind of interesting for 2 seconds, because it's kind of funny to look at a Dillo that can't kill a dodo. But to be honest, it's not very satisfying. You know what, follow me for a second. I really want to try the sprinting thing again. And let's fight with the T-Rex over there. Just to confirm that we aren't taking any damage. Because I think the guy that should deal a lot of damage is a T-Rex. That's the thing. Also, I think I'll just put my armor away so we can try that. Is he even there anymore? Maybe he was trampled to death by the Brontos. No, he's still there trying to bite them. Let's put this guy over there. Let's remove our armor. Whoops, that was a spin. Can I double click it? Oh, I can just double click it. Alright, so let's take a spear. I'm now just in my boxers. So, yeah, sure. And let's try and stab this T-Rex. T-Rex, you want to fight? He's level 10, so let's see. Nope. Nope, he doesn't. Am I god mode or what? No, that doesn't change anything. He just can't hit me. The problem is I can't tell if I'm disabling God Mode or not. It's just it's no, that's not even. That's not cool. But I like the color, to be honest. This red. Pretty cool. Dark red with kind of a mix of green. Really cool color. Now he lost interest and he's trying to eat the Bronto again, which is not helping. So let's try the damage of the spear because I just leveled melee damage twice, I think. So let's see. One step. And a second. A third. Four. Five. Six, seven, eight, nine steps for a level 12 T-Rex. Interesting. Let's take the arms, and the spear because mine, I think mine will break. Also, why the hell not? I take the arrows. Okay. Also, I think I attacked the Bronto. So let's see if this can't hit me. Level 2, so let's test the spear. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, 10, that's interesting. 11? No, that wasn't a hit. Get back here! Oh, he's running. Is he running away? Never seen that happening. Back, you stupid son of a gun. Look at that, I don't even know if I have infinite stats. Well, is this guy biting me now? Yeah, he's. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and he's running away. And the spear broke. Ah, come on! 11. 12. Okay, so I think 13 for the lower one for level 2. That's I don't know what to say. But the color is awesome. God damn it, I should have tamed that one. Wait a second, there's another one? Oh, that's the Bronto. Whoopsie. I would have I was thinking about the T-Rex over there. I love this like red wine color. And I just killed, wait a second. I killed a level, what's this guy? Level 10. Another level 10, I think. This Bronto here. Or level 12, yeah, no, level 10. And I think the other one was level 2. And I got another level up with the XP multiplier all the way up. And I just leveled up, didn't I? So I got what I got a huge boost to experience. Let's just see. So it's 200 and like 55. Yeah, 255 that I need. Okay, let's try this. 255 experience. Yeah, 255 experience left. Let's just try. Whoa, that one's level 21. Okay, let's try this. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 steps for level 21. How much did I get? We were at 25, so 25, 35? No. Give me a second. Need to... We were at 25, weren't we? 30. Did we get 50? 55? Really? Well, it would have been easy, but yeah. Wow. That was a lot of experience for level. No, well, I don't know. Yeah, it should have been a lot of experience for this low level. Well, high level, actually. Higher level. But it's just a scorpion. Scorpions aren't, I don't know, are not the most dangerous guys. But I think 55 experience is a lot. Oh, well, by the way, that's something that we can try. I just learned the engram for the note, even though it's pretty much useless. But from what I've read, and I think I can craft them here, a note should give one experience, because I don't need to create the tribe. Craftables, note. Perfect. So this one should give me one experience if it was on the standard experience multiplier. So let's try this. Oh, there was less than one. Interesting. So maybe because we are at such a high level that we don't get a lot of experience out of that. Well, that was a waste of Engram points. Let's try and harvest a tree and see how much experience we gain out of that. So we are at 50, 81.4. Come on, it's 50, 81.4. So we got about nine experience out of that for one tree, harvesting one tree, and we got about 100 wood out of that. That's just insane, really. Okay, so I think we tested some really interesting stuff. I'm not 100% sure if I like this or not. To be honest, I think it's a bit boring. So I still don't know if I want to. Excuse me, slight hiccups. Shouldn't drink that many carbonated drinks. So yeah, it's pretty interesting. I wouldn't recommend these settings. Don't go to the extremes, but as you can see, it makes for some interesting data, or you can test stuff pretty easily. We have the settings at a such high extreme, such extreme values that dinos can't deal damage anymore, because we turned their damage down a lot. We put the damage that we take down by, I don't know, almost everything. The stamina drain is pretty damn low, because I can just run forever with this scorpion. Or sprint, as you can see, that's the normal move speed, that's sprinting. Normal move speed, sprinting. You can see the tail wiggles a bit, goes up a bit more. So I'm not using stamina for that. Also, if you see the stamina bar flashing, and usually you can't attack forever. It usually takes a lot of stamina to attack, and well, now it's just meh. We're not using anything. So that's that. More settings tested, more to come. Hopefully it will help you to find some settings for your ARK. And I hope we'll see you next time. I'm not 100% sure if I really want to move on with ARK at the moment. I'm kind of, I don't know, burned out with it. All the waiting and what really gets to me is the grind at the moment. I do think that the end game is interesting. I can see that the end game in this is pretty awesome. It still has, I think, 14,000 viewers on Twitch, if you want to have a look there. I didn't watch any Twitch, almost no Twitch stream, just, I think, once or twice I just took a glance, but that's it. Not that I'm opposed to Twitch, I love Twitch, it's an awesome platform for entertainment, just at that. But, yeah, I guess there are a lot of people out there that are still really into this game. The caves, I've seen one of them. I'm not the biggest explorer and stuff like that, so I might turn down my ARK content a bit. I'm kind of trying to find something else at the moment. It's a bit harder. I have to, do a bit more work for university at the moment. So I don't know if I really have the time for for a third series. I might get back into Mass Effect, but seeing that it really hasn't had any views, I'm not that motivated. I mostly play this or do this for myself, but it's also kind of rewarding if you see that people like it, I think. So I might go back to Mass Effect. I'm not 100% sure. It takes a lot of editing, so not something that I can, well, spend my time on, my limited time, because I have to, you know, work and stuff like that. So I don't know how this series will turn out. Maybe it gets a bit on hold or something like that, a bit shorter, a bit less content. I hope to see you in some of my other videos or in the next episode of ARK. And as always, auf Wiedersehen.